Let me tell you how I got started in it. What we call the Phazer Zone Extreme. And teleport him right into that battle and let him become part of it. One of the characters on the TV turns and starts talking to you. See it, you can hear it, and you can feel it. Phazer Zone Extreme is just pure excitement and adrenaline rush.
Phazer Zone Extreme is extreme.
I was born in Terre Haute, Indiana. It's about 50 miles west of Indianapolis, and actually was raised in a little town called Brazil, Indiana, which was a little coal mining and cornfield town. I lived there until 1979 and then came down to Sarasota to visit my parents, who had moved here in 1975 and got the palm tree fever like everyone else and decided to, this is the place for me. My parents are two of the most extremely intelligent, nicest people that anyone could ever meet. They worked very hard all their lives. My dad used to work for a little loan company, and my mother worked for Roots Department Store. She was a buyer for ladies' tops and clothing. One day decided to open up a buffet on Sunday afternoon, which they knew nothing about really being in the restaurant business, except our family were all good cooks. So we opened up the first Sunday, and we had a home-cooked Indiana-style buffet with fried chicken and roast beef and a big salad bar with all the homemade salads that you would see at a Thanksgiving dinner. And they fed over 200 people. And I remember the first day they only had one water pitcher for the whole place. And they had to share that water pitcher through the whole building for 200 people. 4 years later, I moved down and we opened the second Atomai restaurant, which was on the South Trail, where the original Livingston's ended up being in. It was really my dad's dream, although I worked in it and tried very hard in the business. It really wasn't my dream. So in 1979, we had paid the property off on the South Trail, and we had a meeting, and my father asked me, what would you like to do with the rest of your life? And I told him, I said, Dad, anything but the restaurant business. I said, I can't take it another minute. About 4 years ago, I was in Chattanooga, Tennessee on a speaking engagement. I do consulting work for people to set up redemption arcades across the country. And I saw a arena that was called Phazer Zone, and it had glow-in-the-dark paintballs. And the game was played basically with one team on one side of the arena, the other team on the other side of the arena. And there was a scoreboard, and they gave you that might have been a 6 or 8 minute battle experience. And they just played some loud music in there and they turned on the blackout lights, and everybody got to shoot each other back and forth across the arena. What this game really needs is to be themed and to be an experience. I met with the innovator of the Phazer Ball, which was Tom Appleton, who's from Ontario, Canada. I'm going to buy one of these kits from you. I said, I'm going to build an arena, a themed arena. And I said, when I'm done with it, I want you to come down and see it, because you're going to want to be my partner in this. So we went out, we hired the best sound technician we could find. We hired a very creative audiovisual company. And we created what we call the Phazer Zone Extreme. Well, the nice thing about Phazer Zone Extreme is it really appeals to all ages. We like to think our audience is from about age 8 or 9 into 60 or 70.
It's fun.
Okay.
I didn't hurt.
We've had over 20,000 people go through the Phazer Zone Extreme game, and the remarks from the people has just been phenomenal.
It was fun. It was intense. A lot of fun.
And the fact that the projectiles are ultraviolet, when they go across the arena, they glow like a phaser. These sensor vests that you wear for protection have impact sensors in them, which score on a scoreboard through a radio frequency. There are also some special home-based targets that you can shoot at for points and score in the game also. And, of course, the team with the most points wins the end of the battle.
Last humans lost. Well, humans beat us.
Learned that we had to show the rules by acting it out to people. We had to tell them the rule and be able to allow them to read the rule on the screen, which we didn't do in the beginning. Because you've got basically a minute and a half to teach people 13 rules in the game and be able to put them in an arena that they've never seen and be able to understand how to play and win the game. Some of the rules that we added to the game was at the end of the battle, we asked the player to lay their weapon on the floor and stand up with their hand in the air.
Cease fire! Cease fire!
We experienced that after the battle was over, a lot of people continued to fire, and we were ended up telling him some of these rules after the battle was over. So we, you know, with trial and error, we adjusted the rules accordingly and made it to where it was safe for everyone to play the game.
It's a lot of fun. It's way more intense than laser tag.
The biggest problem we had is, you know, is not copyright infringing upon anybody else's rights. For example, the Star Trek movie picture and series, The Borg. We had to be careful not to use the word Borg, not to take any of their theatrical design. You know, we had to design our own, we call Cyborg, which is a generic name. Everything had to be generically done. We had to use generic music that there were no copyright infringements on. We did our first national show where we debuted the game, the world's largest entertainment show for parks, recreation, amusement facilities. We were able to meet a company from England called Monkey Biz. We were able to sell a unit, our first unit that we're installing in a little town called Poole, England. It has the potential of making $900 an hour in full capacity. We have a company in Queensbury, New York that's interested in purchasing one for this summer. We have another contact in North Carolina, Fort Lauderdale, Dubai. All over the world, we have people that will probably be installing these.
All right, everybody, take your mask. Oh my God. Walk towards the exit doors now.
Well, I just like to tell people, you know, the best investment you can make in yourself is in yourself. If you have a dream or something that you believe in, it's nice to consult with other people. If I did what everybody told me to do, I probably maybe wouldn't have never done the Phazer Zone. I believed in it. I believed in myself. I can tell people to stay with your dream. One thing that people that have been successful have had is they made many mistakes, but they kept going. And so my advice to people is never give up on your dream and keep running into that wall, and finally you'll break through.
You just gotta survive.